Hi, this is Sriyank Siddhartha and welcome to another video on Kotlin programming. Recently, I was going through a lot of blogs and threads on Stack Overflow where there is a confusion regarding the val keyword. The most common misconception about the val keyword among the beginners is that they think it is immutable in nature. So in this short video, I will talk about what exactly is the val keyword. Is it immutable, read-only, write-only, or what? So let's get started. So let's find it out. Is it really immutable? If not, what is it exactly? Suppose we have a class box with a property height with value equal to 10. And within the main function, we create a box object. And suppose we try to change the height value by reassigning a new value to it, like this. Then what will happen? Well, this statement will throw an error. Why? Because we know that if you use val while defining a property and initialize the variable with some initial value, then you cannot change its value in future. So this much we know from the basics of Kotlin. And of course, we can read this property value anywhere in our code. For example, in this print statement, we can read its value and print the value. So this statement will print 10 in the output console. So at present, we can say that this property height is read-only, as we can only read its value, but also immutable in nature, because we are unable to change its value in our program. Right? So the way this property is defined makes it immutable. But let's not hurry to make a final judgment about the val keyword, because we don't know that this height is immutable because of the val keyword or because of the way it is defined over here. So let's dig deeper and find out more. So let us define another property, this time width. So here we are using the val keyword, and attached to it is a getter function. So this getter function returns a random number from 1 up to 15. So within the main function, if you use box.width equal to 12, that is, we are again reassigning a new value to the width property. Then this time again, this statement will throw an error. Because since it is val, so we are not allowed to reassign a new value to a val property. Fine, so again we already know it. But if you try to read its value, such as within these print statements, then each time you read its value, you will get a new value in the output console. Why? Because the getter of this property is returning a random number. So looking at these different values, I am sure that this width is not at all immutable in nature, as its value keeps on changing whenever we access it. So we can say that this property is read-only, but at the same time, it is not immutable. Fine. So looking at these two comments, we can say that the usage of val had no impact on the immutability of the property. So it is quite obvious that val does not exactly mean immutable. As simple as that. But in these two definitions, we have one thing in common. Both the properties are read-only. So from this, we can infer that val is just read-only and nothing else. So if you use val, then your property becomes read-only. So please note this. This is what this video is all about. So once you define a property using val, then you can never ever reassign it a new value, which you can see in the main function. So to conclude, val is just read-only. So now, what is immutability here? So if you notice, we have defined val height equal to 10. Now since we are using val, so height becomes read-only. And since we have already assigned it a constant value of 10, so the value of height will never change in our program. So this makes our property as read-only and immutable. The immutability of a property in Kotlin depends on the way we define a property in our code, not just on the val keyword itself. So again, note this. So yes, this was a very short video on the val keyword and its property. So if you have gained something from this video, then give this video a thumbs up. And to support this video, comment in the comment box below. This is Sriyank Siddhartha signing off. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.